What's up, you guys? It's Susan Morad, right back here on Clever News. And in a new interview about her smash hit single Driver's License, Olivia Rodrigo is detailing the exact moment she found out that Taylor Swift fangirled over her first number one hit.
Even if you're not currently going through a breakup or involved in a teenage love triangle, Olivia Rodrigo's emotional new single, Driver's License, was a swift kick to the feels. The song has been all the rage among the internet over the past week, as it's already peaked at number one on iTunes, Spotify, Apple Music, and more. Millions of fans have been able to relate to the song, in large part due to the detailed and emotionally painful lyrics about a breakup. That said, Driver's License has earned massive amounts of praise from fans and artists all over the world, including Joe and Kevin Jonas, and one of the greatest known songwriters of our generation, Taylor Swift, who commented on Olivia's original post in full fangirl mode. While noting that her song trailed directly behind Taylor's two Evermore bonus tracks on the charts, Taylor responded to Olivia's post with a quote her own mother, Andrea Swift, previously used to describe Taylor, writing, "I say that's my baby and I'm really proud." Olivia, who first stepped onto the scene on the Disney Plus show High School Musical, The Musical, The Series, first caught the attention of Swifties when she posted a cover of one of Taylor's songs back in April. She recently sat down with Apple Music and dished on the first time she learned that she was on Taylor's radar, saying, quote, "I've never met her in person, but I posted a cover of one of her songs off of Lover, Cruel Summer, like a weirdo, and I did it on Instagram Live, and she found it and she posted it on her story and was like, this is amazing, thank you so much, and I screamed my head off, I was so excited." Like Taylor, Olivia tapped into her own personal experience to write Driver's License following a breakup that left her completely heartbroken.
Yeah, so I wrote the bulk of the song, like, literally crying in my living room, and I think that it definitely had that feel to it.
She went on to explain, "I was driving around my neighborhood, actually listening to really sad songs and crying in the car. And I got home and I was like, maybe I'll write a song about this, crying in the car. So I just sat down at my piano and plucked out some chords that I liked, and it kind of happened that way. But it was really, really natural and organic. Very much me writing in the depth of my emotion." Olivia never in a million years expected the song to gain this much traction, especially from her own idol. And while she describes herself as the biggest Swiftie in the whole world, she recalls feeling at a complete loss for words after finding out about Taylor's reaction to her song.
Like, I was dead asleep and my friend called me on the phone and I was like, oh my God, it's like 6 a.m. Can I like call you back in 2 hours? And he's like, no, absolutely not. Check your Instagram right now.
She went on to explain, quote, "And in the grogginess of my sleep, I checked my phone and she commented on my photo and I just about died. Just about died. Literally. I've looked up to her as long as I can remember. So it was so sweet of her to do that." Something tells me that if Taylor and Olivia were to ever collaborate one day, the result would be some sort of All Too Well 2.0 that would literally run me over like a train. Not sure if the world is ready for that just yet. But as Swifties are well aware, Taylor doesn't just publicly fangirl over anyone. So in case you aren't aware, Olivia surely is something special and we can't wait to see what's in store for her next.
And for a full breakdown of the love triangle between Olivia, Joshua and Sabrina Carpenter, click right over here for another clever video. Then be sure to let me know your thoughts on Olivia's reaction to Taylor's remark in the comments section below. I'm your host, Susan Morad. You can find me on Instagram @Susan_Morad. I'll catch you later. Bye, guys.